the last episode of Late Night Charge for the season. I am Joe Brown, here with my co-host Dave Puglisi. Dave, we got a good one today.
Yeah, Joe, but it's a sad moment. This is the last one of the year.
Listen, it's going to be a long summer without the Charge, I understand. But we have a show to do, so let's get it started.
But it hits me in the feels, Joe Brown.
Conceal, don't feel, Dave. Florida State football player Jameis Winston is back in the news again for all the wrong reasons. He was suspended from the Florida State baseball team for stealing king crab legs from a local supermarket. When asked why he did it, he said he forgot to pay.
Man, this guy really loves shoplifting, huh, Joe Brown?
Yeah, Dave, this isn't the first time he's been caught stealing. An Alabama supermarket even renamed their king crab legs Jameis Winston crab legs.
You know, Joe, it's the biggest mistake he made was he made the big jump to the king crab legs.
What do you mean?
I mean, you gotta start small, right? Like, you should be trying to work for, like, the lower level of the king family. So, like it should be, like, the princess crab legs, maybe you should start with. Or, you know, you're getting me, like, the jester crab legs.
Infiltrate the king crab family?
Yes, and then work your way up to the big time. I mean, clearly he wasn't ready. That's a mistake that Johnny Manziel wouldn't make. He is an expert at this kind of stuff, Joe.
I think you're completely misunderstanding how crab legs work. Like, it's not just a big, like Godfather family.
No, why would they be called the king crab legs? Like, why else would they be called that? I don't know, but hey, I can tell you one thing for sure. You definitely can't get those at Bartels. And that means I'm going to have a word with Miss Mary about that.
No, I don't think you would want crab legs from Bartels. Some of the stuff they put out sometimes, like, I think it would be, if we had crab legs, like all that seafood and stuff, it would be a rush to the bathroom.
No, come on.
You, okay. I don't want to get into this discussion on TV because it could lead down a really bad road knowing Dave. So a recent Cornell study shows that kids that eat more chicken off the bone end up more aggressive than kids that eat boneless chicken. Do you eat boneless chicken, Dave?
Why are you asking me this question, Joe, huh? You think I just eat boneless chicken? What do you want from me?
What are you talking about, Dave? I just asked you a simple question.
I didn't think it was simple, and I thought it was an overstepping of our bounds.
You're making me cough over here. Like, I'm really nervous. I think...
you okay?
I think that answered my question.
Choking on it?
Listen.
The chicken?
You're not helping the situation. You're making... That answered my question.
All right.
I just thought you liked chicken, Dave. That was all.
Yeah. That's what I thought you meant by this whole thing.
So... No, I'm better now. Justin Bieber's back in the news. While in a nightclub in Toronto, he asked former mayor Rob Ford for crack.
Crack cocaine.
Yes.
That is an illegal drug.
This enraged
Ford. It's illegal.
Ford then disappears to the bathroom for hours, and when he got out, Ford said that he was in over his head.
Yeah, man. First of all, Ford is a big boy. Right?
Yeah.
So I imagine when Ford goes to the bathroom, he is in over his head, Joe Brown.
What? No, Dave, they're not... They're not saying he, like, went to the bathroom.
No,
like, he wasn't going to the bathroom.
I think that's what the article said, word for word, Joe. And you know, you brought it up earlier. You know what it's like to be in over your head after Bartels. You can time that, Joe. You can time it. 30 minutes after you eat a chicken patty.
Are you ever, like, you ever go to Bartels, like, with your friend? And then, like, you finish your food first and, like, they still haven't, like, they're talking to people or whatever. Like, they're talking, like, they didn't finish. And, like... Do you want nothing more in life than for them to be done so you can leave?
I wish I could relate to this, but I don't have friends, Joe.
Oh, sorry.
I don't go to Bartels with anybody. I go by myself. I leave when I want.
I guess that's the one plus that someone's ever found for not having friends.
Yeah, man. I'm on my own schedule. I don't have to worry about anybody else but myself. Me, myself, and I. And stuff.
An Ohio man called 911 on his grandson for being lazy, Dave. And all he did, he asked him to clean up the house, you know, whatever. And then the grandson decided to just keep playing his games on his computer. Then the police arrived. And
The police actually showed up, Joe?
Yeah, they showed up. According to the report, they were able to...
No, Joe, do you see the problem here? Do you not see what the problem is?
What?
We could get in trouble for playing chow.
How do you make that connection?
I'm like a felon. Man, you know the times you've called me up and been like, bro, come over. And I'm like, busy playing chill by myself.
Are you chilling like a felon?
Oh, my God, you went there. That was good. I liked it. I liked
High
that.
Five.
Yeah. Chalk went up for Joe Brown. It's one funny.
So a French tourist is circling the internet for giving a homeless man some pizza in New York. Only problem is this homeless man was actually the actor Richard Gere. The woman walked onto the set of Time Out of Mind and said to Gere, "Sorry, but it's cold." And Gere responded with, "Thank you and God bless." So, I mean, it really sounds like it could be a homeless man, but it was Richard Gere, an actor.
You know what, Joe? These homeless men, they got it made, man. They just sit around, they don't even have a job, and they get free money from people, and they get free pizza. I mean, what's a guy gotta do to get a free pizza around here?
But you're missing the point how it wasn't a homeless man. It was, like, critically acclaimed actor
then
Richard
why
Gere.
Why was he on the street, Joe?
Because he was playing
you
an
know what?
Old homeless
these,
man.
These homeless guys, look at them. They're getting movie deals now, huh? I'm sitting here on the set of the Late Night Charge, just trying to make it in this world, in this field of communications. And this kid sitting on the street, boom, free pizza, boom. Oh, he gets a movie deal. What's up with that, Joe? You know, some people have all the luck.
I guess it's just the American dream, Dave. You're a lost cause.
It is.
A Florida man was taking a selfie with a squirrel when the squirrel turned around and attacked him.
Ground control to Major Tom. Ground control to Major Tom. Take your...
Did you see that list of deadliest animals, Joe?
Yeah, I mean, there was a lot. I think mosquitoes and humans were number one and two.
And you know what number three was? Killer squirrels, Joe Brown. They're everywhere. I see them running around campus. I see those guys sitting there, like, eating their nuts, nonchalantly, like, ooh, I'm not going to try to kill you right now, Joe. You know what? I walk on the other side of the sidewalk, and I see one of those kids running around, little squirrels. And they're all in, like, different colors. What's up with that? They're gray, they're brown, they're black. Some of them are red. I've seen red ones, Joe.
No, it's actually like snails and like live water snails or some crap like that.
Freshwater snails,
thank you.
What? Why are snails in the water, Joe?
They're one of the deadliest animals in the world.
Why are snails in the water? Spring break, never go into water ever again. No way. Snails everywhere. They're going to kill you. Watch yourself. It's spring weekend. You can get hurt. Freshwater snails. They kill.
So a California prisoner is actually suing Jay-Z, Beyonce, and others for $2.4 million for going to the FBI, CIA, and others and taking lyrics that he wrote behind bars. Although no one really thinks he's going to win this battle.
You know what, Joe? This rapping stuff is easy.
Dave, you cannot rap.
Yeah, I can, Joe Brown.
What are you doing?
Uh-huh. What up?
What is this?
Yep! This is the Late Night Charge. Yeah, huh? Ready for this? Dropping bars. I'm on the Late Night Charge with my boy Joe Brown. People think he's smart, but he's really a clown. Producers are yelling in my ear, Jeff Rogers and Schnabel all up in my ear. Tell me to take it easy because I'm dropping sick beats up in here. Just call me Jay-Z because I'm a player. Others be hating, but y'all, see you later.
Dave, give me the mic. Stop. I'll see you later, Dave.
You're not even cool, Joe.
Well, we have a great show for you tonight. We have USGA Treasurer-elect Jonathan Anthony Foti, one of my favorite people in the whole world, one of Dave's also. We also have the musical guest performance Common Ground. They're pretty cool. Stay tuned. This is Late Night Charge.
January 10th. The radio says that the few left alive are beginning to rebuild down in Boston. Amazing to think that all this started with a fever. Something as simple as that. By the time anyone knew what was happening, it was already too late. Perhaps it was the world's way of balancing itself out. I don't know. They say it's all over now, that the plague has run its course. They say this and that and talk some more. Who truly knows? They've been filling our minds with hope, but I don't know if I'm ready for starting over. I need more time.
Welcome back to Late Night Charge. Please welcome our first guest, the new USGA Treasurer, John Anthony Foti.
Got
Hey, what's going on? You look good.
Oh, thanks.
I mean, that's nothing new. You're always looking good. You're always looking very dapper.
I try.
I think, have the reputation on campus as the most well-dressed human being.
You know, it's very flattering.
Besides me, of course.
Yeah, besides Dave, but...
He wasn't even nominated for the award.
I go to Savers for all my dress clothes, so...
But, no, that adds to it. You go to Savers, so... You know, he spends all his mom's money on fancy clothes. Yeah.
Who said
and
I spend all my mom's money?
You go to Savers, get like some $5.
I go to Savers because of budget cuts. I go to Savers because I got, you know, no money.
Is that what helped you get USJ Treasurer?
Yep. You know, got to pinch the pennies.
So you just had the last USGA for the year, yep. And now you're the new treasurer. How's it feel? Like, I know it was like cool to win, but like now it's like everything really is yours.
Well, you know, it kind of hasn't like sat in yet, but you know, it probably will like 3 months from now when we come back to school and everyone's, you know, wondering where their money is and I ran off with it and no longer go to the school anymore. But
just embezzles all the USGA money.
Embezzle all the money, but no, seriously. No, it's fun. I don't know. We did the big budget and that went up today and it passed. Great. So now I have a job for next year and I don't know. Look forward to doing it.
Well, I mean, speaking of big budget, we know that sometimes like some names like can be a little controversial, can be a little hurtful. Like, did you never think about the budget's failings when you called it big?
I mean,
you couldn't have like been more like PC with it?
That, I guess, is the politically correct term.
Like a big bone budget?
It's like the big budget. I mean, I don't know what else you want me to, like, I'm not going to sugarcoat it. I'm going to tell how it is. I mean, you want to call me a little budget, medium-sized budget?
No, I don't know.
I saw the big budget. It was like...
I mean, that binder was huge. You know what I had to do to find stuff for that budget?
What?
Find the money and the funding.
How did you find money for big budget?
Myself and the budget
committee. I was informed.
We went down to the West Haven beaches with our metal detectors, and we scoured the beaches for all the loose change and rings to fill the budget. And you know what? We only had $20 to disperse among 175 organizations. So.
I bet you found money was tight. But you found more condoms and broken glass than money.
A ton.
Have you ever actually been to a beach cleanup?
No. Yes.
What?
There was one this morning, but I couldn't go because of the
meeting. I don't know. It's kind of cool because like you feel like you're helping like society, but at the same time, like you realize like 12 hours from now, it's going to be terrible again.
Yeah. Well, like the beach cleanups, you go there, it's like you pick up 3 things of trash. It's like, all right, I did my fill. Let's go lay in the sun.
No, I remember I went one time and I just found the most ridiculous stuff on the beach. Like I filled up 2 bags with Davy J and it was just like parts of like, you know, like you'd find kites, and then you'd find like parts of like, looks like dog houses. I was like, what is this here?
Broken dreams of West Haven.
Yeah. All over the place. Deflated basketballs. I'm like, let's get here. Like,
who plays basketball on the beach?
That's what I'm saying.
Don't even bounce it. It defeats the purpose.
I found a lot of weird things, man.
Many of which I can't name. It is the beach, so.
Well, going back to USGA, you've been pretty, it's who you are yes. now for the next year.
Yeah.
Like, you just can't get around it. Every time someone sees you, it's the USGA treasurer.
It's that guy that took my money.
Right.
Or didn't give us the money.
Or didn't give us money, hashtag com club.
Yeah.
I digress. I'm just kidding. It's whatever. It was our first time.
It wasn't my decision.
It was cool.
But it was.
No, he has a whole committee.
He's
a figurehead.
This year, actually, that was the tough part. You know, I go on the budget committee and I kind of sit there and, you know, I sit through the meetings and I just take notes. No opinion, no say, just the budget committee.
Really?
One. Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
It's pretty interesting, actually. So don't come crying to me.
Fody posts on Facebook. Yeah, here's the names and phone numbers of everybody who made the decision to cut your budget.
Yeah. But no, it was great. Like I said, it was, I know I was a little bit worried, but the budget passed today, so everybody's got budgets for next year, so it's awesome.
Well, you've been in USGA since freshman year, right? Yep. Were you a senator freshman year?
I was a club rep for my first 2 years, and then this year I was a senator for the whole year.
All right. Well, I mean, just out of curiosity, why? I mean, you got to wake up every Friday morning.
You know what it was?
Like,
it was,
that's a lot of work.
It was a lot of work, but my first 2 semesters freshman year, I had 8 a.m. classes. On Fridays, and so I was like, whatever. And I said, you know, what am I going to do for the rest of the day on Fridays? And, you know, USGA seemed kind of cool, and club needed someone to go, so I'm like, all right, well, I guess I'll go. And then I liked it. And wanted to get more involved and wanted to see how everything worked. And then, you know, I thought about it, and treasurer seemed kind of cool, and then I did it, and
now I'm here.
And we'll see what happens.
Yeah, we'll see what happens. You wanted this.
This is your fault.
This is your fault, UNH.
You wanted this.
That's just every time like something goes wrong, you say, you wanted this.
Yeah, you wanted it.
You asked for it.
Now, I don't know if you remember, but I remember when we first met.
I do.
John Foti.
I remember.
It was the summer of 2012.
Right. Yep.
And we happened to be summer roommates.
We were.
For orientation.
Orientation.
And it was quite fun, mm-hmm. to my memory, right?
It was the best day of my life.
The best day of your life?
Yep, best day of my life.
Out of all the days of your life that you've ever had.
All the days of June 2012, summer, on June 9th. That was the best day of my life.
That was the best option. All right. You know what?
Out of all the June 9ths that I've ever had, that was the best.
I remember the day. It was a balmy 75 degrees outside, and you know, I walked up
in June,
and I said, "Who is this dashing young man in a pair of gym shorts and
T-shirt?" And then our other roommate Edward was who you're referring to. And then I peeked up behind him.
Joe Brown came out from the bathroom in just a towel, and he said, "Hi, I'm Joe Brown. What's up?" And I said, "That's not going to happen.
This can never happen again.
This is not going to happen." But no, it was great. We had a blast, right?
Yeah, it was fun. We would just just spend every day and just like, I don't know.
We did orientation leader stuff.
Yeah, that was cool.
Make poster boards and
poster boards, water coolers.
Yeah. Oh man. I don't even want to get in. Oh my god, I just like thinking just those words like together. Just oh my god, make me feel bad. So what's coming up for the summer for John Foti?
Summer. Well, this summer again, I'm doing orientation.
Cool.
Love the orientation program. It's fun. And that's about it. Preparing for next year for treasurer stuff. You know, doing some office work here or there. To kind of get ready so that when the semester starts, everybody's good to go and can get their money on time and do events. So nothing too exciting.
You start like it's like a financial year or something
like
that, right?
The fiscal year.
So you start on July 1st?
Yeah, July 1st is when I actually like take office.
Does that mean on June 30th you're going ham?
Oh yeah. Clear. Yeah, all day. All that.
Blowing fat stacks.
That's good. Remember how I said June 9th was the best day of my life? July 1st is going to be the worst day of my life.
Worst day of life? It's just like, I feel like if I was ever elected official or whatever and I became a lame duck president or treasurer like Zani and Isaac have, like, I would just like stop. I would just like stop. And be like, just let them handle it. Like, I'm graduating. I would totally have senioritis like in October. Like, I would just let someone else do the work for me.
Hey, well. We'll see what happens, though. I look forward to it. Like I said, you know, I wouldn't have done it if I didn't think I could do it, but at the same time, it's going to be a lot of work.
We asked for it.
Yeah, you guys asked for it.
We asked for it. This is it.
There were other options.
How do you think you're going to work with the new president, Rich Rotella?
I think we'll work great. I've known Rich since my freshman year, so, you know, we've always kind of gotten along, and I worked with him a lot, actually, this year in the office, so, you know, our relationship is pretty good, and the e-board that Rich is putting up, you know, seems really cool, so I think it's going to be a great year.
All right. Well, we wish you the best of luck. It's always wonderful. We have to have you on again next year. Maybe so excited. He's
That's
so
it.
Eager and excited and ready now.
That's it.
But let's get him on in like November maybe. Let's see. You know, let's see what happens.
I'll probably have gray hair. I'm probably coming
beard down to here, just like you
what
know.
What are you doing with your life? I'm homeless. All the money gone.
Showing his Vietnam War stories.
I got mugged. All the money's gone.
All of it's gone. No budget for
it's an offshore account for you.
Swiss bank accounts. I'm looking into it right now. You know?
All right. Well, thanks, buddy. We'll see you. Have a great summer. Have a great orientation.
Thanks,
hopefully you don't lose our money.
I'll try not to. I'll try to do my best.
When we come back, we'll have the musical guest, Common Ground. Stay tuned. This is Late Night Charge.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening, folks.
How is everybody tonight?
How are you guys doing?
Why are you copying me?
You're my role model. I do what you do.
Ah, I see. Certainly was a good dinner we had last night.
Sure was. It was delicious.
Could have used a beer and some tequila shots.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. I don't agree with that.
But you're supposed to follow my lead.
Not in this. I'm no dummy.
Welcome back to Late Night Charge. Please welcome our musical guest, Common Ground. How are you guys doing today?
Great.
Good.
Thanks for
doing good. So I got to listen to some of your music before. You guys are pretty cool. You guys have a Facebook page, right?
We do, yep. Under the name of Common Ground.
Well, one of the song you're gonna play today, I heard, and it's a cool, it's like a cool like rendition. And I know a lot of people start like doing acoustic covers and stuff. So how do you come up? It sounds different than the original song. So how do you guys come up with like, you know, musically and like trying to make your own flair to like a song?
Well, ironically, we don't really have a method. We just kind of play it, and sometimes stuff just kind of happens. I don't know.
Last night we tried to watch a video, like a 24-minute straight video of top 100 songs of the 2000s, and it did not work at all.
Yeah, we learned that last night. So.
It was not good.
What were some of the songs?
Like Britney Spears and Beyonce. I mean, as much as we'd like to be single ladies, but I mean,
a lot of Ja Rule came up.
I would rock that.
A lot of Ja Rule.
A lot more Ja Rule than I expected.
Yeah.
Alright, so, where do you guys live? Are you all, like, close to each other, or...?
I'm from Milford, I'm right down the road.
Yeah, I'm from Boston, but, I mean, we're all in the same suite in Botwinick, if that's what you're asking. I don't really know what you're asking.
Well, just in general, like, I didn't know if you guys were a band before college, or...
Oh, no.
Just happen to be, like, friends in the
music happen to live
area.
Together.
Yeah, they live together.
Chance.
Alright, so, Common Ground, I'm gonna try to assume where the name is coming from before I sound stupid. Where, like, where'd you guys come up with that name?
Well, since we live in a suite, three guys and three guys, the band always practiced in the common room. And it took us, like, a couple days to come up with a name because we didn't really like anything. So we just kind of went really basic. We're like, this is the common room. And we don't like the name common room. It's kind of dumb. So we just...
The ground.
Ground. Yeah, common ground.
That we played on.
See, I thought it was, like common ground, like, you guys, like, you're from Milford, you're from Boston, like, you're from different, like, areas, but, like, you still love
not
music.
As deep as you
actually,
would think.
Actually, that's a lot deeper, yeah.
Right? That's what I'm trying to help you out here. I'm trying to make you sound, like, get all the way, like, oh, they're so deep.
We're going to go with that from now on.
That's all right. We're going to lie about that now.
All right, so what are your, like, plans for the future? What are you guys doing for the summer?
We don't know what we can do for the summer.
Practice?
Yeah, we just practice on our own, I guess.
In our rooms?
Yeah.
Are you... Well, you're percussion, so are you just going to, like, sit there and, like pretend that they're there with you and just wait for your times to, like, hit the
probably.
Thing?
I'm still trying to figure out my plans, but that's probably going to become it.
Okay. And then is that, like, any fun trips? Anything?
Well, we're looking around... Actually, there's a fourth member to our band, our guitarist, but he couldn't make it today. He knows a couple of places in New York. He's from New York, and we're thinking about maybe getting together at one point, maybe playing some shows up there, or like a middle of the road for all of us, kind of like in between all of us, common ground for all of us, and playing there. You know, just playing
see,
a couple
it
shows.
Works.
So well.
So yeah.
All right. Well, I wish you guys the best of luck. You know, you guys are pretty awesome. Promote the Facebook page and everything. We'll have a link. So, when we come back, Common Ground will perform, so stay tuned. This is Late Night Charge. Welcome back to Late Night Charge. Please welcome our musical guests, Common Ground.
Someone like you and all you know and how you speak. Endless lovers undercover on the streets. You know that I could use somebody. You know that I could use somebody.
Common Ground. Thank you for coming on, guys. Stay tuned. We'll be right back. This is Late Night Charge.
Adolescents are faced with peer pressure almost daily.
Come on, we've been friends forever. One drink won't hurt.
Are you really gonna embarrass me again?
Don't be such a stick in the mud, Camille. It's just a couple of drinks.
I don't need to drink to fit in. I'm my own person.
Sometimes all a child needs is a guiding hand. If you talk to them seriously about alcohol use, they'll listen. And when the time comes, they'll make the choice you want them to. The right choice.
Welcome back to Late Night Charge. We've had another great episode, Dave.
It's a fantastic.
Unfortunately, it's the end of the season. We're going on summer break.
Yep.
So, but it's been a great season. I just want to thank everyone, all the guests that we've had, all the musical performances, all the USGA people, and everyone from the club.
Even today. Foley coming on, Common Ground. It's a great show.
It was great. I also wanted to thank all the crew. Couldn't do the show without you. They do the lights and the cameras and everything and the audio. So they're really important. All part of the Communication Club. They're a Communication Club, a bunch of great people. So thank you all.
If you want to be a part of it, come out, join the club at any time. Talk to me or Joe. Stop by the studio. You can join the Communication Club and make whatever you want.
And also, if you want to be on Late Night Charge, we get in the emails for all the episodes. We have some producers. Hit them up. We go on UNH Late Night Charge on YouTube, obviously.
Find us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram.
And we look forward to having you on the show for next season. So have a great summer. Love you all. This is Late Night Charge.